Hi, welcome to Online Laboratory course on Computer Aided Power System Analysis Laboratory. The course code is EEE71, experiment number is 4, and the title of the experiment is Y-bus Formation for Power System by Direct Inspection Method. So, the Y-bus formation can be done by two methods. One is direct inspection method and one more is a singular transformation method. Both the thing we can do by using the MATLAB coding. So our aim of this experiment is to form a Y-bus matrix for the given power system network by inspection method using MATLAB. So the formula for finding out the Y-bus by inspection method is: the diagonal element of the Y-bus matrix we can able to find out by the summation of all the admittance on injected to that particular bus. So the off diagonal element can be the negative sign of the line admittance. Suppose if a problem is given to you to find out or to perform the Y-bus matrix by inspection method, then so here also one problem is given: the determine Y-bus matrix by inspection method for the given power system. The impedance data for the sample network is shown in the below table. Consider the bus 0 as a reference. So in this question they have given the network to you and also they have given the table to you. In this table you can find out the self impedance of every lines which is given here. This diagram you can see it is a 4 bus system. The 0th bus they have considered the reference and bus 1, 2, 3 are the buses having different lines. Say between bus 1 and 2 there is a line flowing and it impedance, self impedance is 0.02 plus j 0.6. so like that respectively for all the lines they have given the data. So for this particular network we need to find out the Y-bus matrix by inspection method. So how to perform that? The first step we need to do is we need to find out the admittance for all the impedance that given in the question. Here you can see from bus code 0 to 1 the impedance value is 0.02 plus j 0.6. so this is the impedance value given for this particular bus code 01. So if you divide this by 1, we will get the admittance. Respectively, all the admittance value we need to convert as the admittance, sorry, all the impedance value we need to convert into the admittance form, and we need to keep that data ready. Second step is we need to form the Y-bus matrix as given in this matrix. You can see that Y11, Y12, Y13, Y21, Y22, Y23, Y31, Y32, Y33. Because here, even though there are 4 buses, we should not take the reference bus for the Y-bus formation. So if I exclude this reference bus 0, then I will get 3 bus. If 3 bus is the system have, then the Y-bus matrix will be 3 by 3 matrix. So the first thing we need to understand that the Y-bus matrix will be always the number of the buses available here excluding the reference bus. So obviously we will get 3 by 3 reference or 3 by 3 matrices for my Y-bus. You can see this Y11, Y22, Y33 are the diagonal element. For that diagonal element we already know the formula is nothing but the summation of all the admittance connected to this bus. Say for example Y11 is nothing but this is the Y11. I hope the pointer is visible to you. Y11 is the admittance available in bus 1, total admittance available in bus 1. So if you add the line element, line bus 12 and 10, then you will get the Y11 value. Respectively for Y22, if you add this bus and this 12, bus 02, bus line 32, so if you add this 3, you will get the total value as Y22. Same like this for Y33 is nothing but Add this 2, that is 03 and 23 line admittance, and you will get Y33. Okay, so all this line admittance we already found in step 1 here, just divided by 1 divided by the impedance value, you will get the admittance. By keeping this, just add all the diagonal element for the respective line admittance value. How to do that? Here you can see in this slide, we have taken the diagonal elements of Y11, Y22, Y33. All these diagonal elements are nothing but the summation of all its admittance which is connected to that bus. Say for example, Y11 is connected to Y01, Y01 is this line, and plus Y12 is this. So if you are adding this 2, you will get Y11 as value as 0.11 minus J3.32. This is the addition of this Y01, Y12. If you add this 2, you will get this value. Same like that, if you see this Y22, that is second bus admittance, you can see 3 lines are connected here. So 3 lines, what are those lines? 1-2, line 1-2, line 0-2, line 3-2. So if you add these 3 elements or these 3 lines, you will get the total self-admittance of this bus Y22. Respectively, for Y33 also, there are 2 lines connected to this bus. If you add these 2, then you will get the total admittance of Y33. So this is for a diagonal element. So in this formula also you can see for the diagonal element it is simple. Next thing is off diagonal element. Off diagonal element, whatever the, say for example Y12, here Y12, the red color Y12 and Y21 both are same. So how to get that value? Y12 is nothing but Y21 and it's nothing but minus of Y12. So here Y12 value we know, that is nothing but this value. We need to put the same value here, but we need to multiply it with minus. So we will get the minus value for Y12 and Y21. Same like that for Y13 and Y31, both are same and it's equal to minus of Y31. But you can see that Y13 and Y31 are not available because there is no any line between bus 1 and 3. There is no any line here. So obviously the value will be 0. But if we see Y23, here Y23 and 32 are same. That is why it is given in yellow. This two yellow values, that is nothing but Y23 and 32, are the value of minus 23. So here 23 value is 0.079 minus J19. Just multiply it with minus, so you will get this value. So these non-diagonal elements are very simple. Just give the minus value to that and the value will be taken. So that is why it is given as for off diagonal element, Y bus is Yij is nothing but minus of Yij. So after completing this, you can see here the diagonal elements value is taken and put in the black color in Y bus. This is the total Y bus matrix. In this Y bus matrix, by inspection method, what we have find out is the diagonal element is nothing but the summation of all the elements connected to that particular bus, and then off diagonal element is nothing but the values which is already available, just we need to multiply it with minus, then we will get the value. This is the theoretical calculation for the given problem. So same how we can do with MATLAB is the question mark. Practically we can write a code in MATLAB for finding out the Y bus using the inspection method. Let's see, this is the total program. We'll see one step by step so that it will be very clear for you. What are the steps available generally for doing this Y bus matrix by inspection method? First thing, we need to get the value of number of lines available. What are the, how many number of lines is there? That is the first data we need to get. And then second, we need to get the data of number of buses excluding reference bus. Say for example, if you have 4 bus And in that four bus, if you have only one reference bus, then the total bus will be number will be three. So we need to get total number of buses excluding the reference bus. Third step is we need to form the empty bus, means all zeros, but the size should the size of this matrix should be number of bus times the number of bus. So the 3x3 matrix we will get for the example we have taken. Because the size of the bus is 3, so the Y bus matrix size will be 3 cross 3, right? And then getting the line impedance value for the all buses and from starting to ending. Say for example, here say the from bus is 0 to bus is 1. So from this, from bus 0 to from to bus 1, the value is 0.055 minus j 1.66. so this is nothing but from bus 0 to bus 1. Same like this, line 2 is nothing but bus 1, from bus 1 to bus 2, and line 3 is from bus 2 to bus 3, line 4 is from bus 3 to bus 0. So like this we need to get all the impedance value for different lines. So that is why this step is taken. So getting the fourth step is getting line impedance value for all from bus FB and to bus TB. So this data we need to collect. After that we need to give these values to our system. From this value we need to calculate the admittance. Admittance is nothing but whatever value we are getting in step 4, we need to divide it by 1. So then we will get step 5. After getting step 5, we need to form Y bus. Then we need to print Y bus. So this is the step we need to follow while writing the code in MATLAB. Let's check how the code will be for this 7 step. The first step is getting number of lines. So NL is the variable I am creating, is equal to taking input, and inside this bracket have taken number of lines just to tell the user to enter the number of lines. So whatever the value they are given, it will be stored in NL, the variable NL. Once you got, if you got this NL value, then we are going to check for NB. NB is nothing but number of buses. Here we are clearly mentioned that the number of buses excluding the reference bus. So how many buses are there? They are minus 1 reference bus, so you will get total number of buses. So that value are going to store in NB. Then you are going to form a zero matrix with the size of NB comma NB. NB is nothing but number of bus comma number of bus. So now NB cross NB size of matrix you are going to form with zeros, means nothing but an empty matrix we are making for Y bus. Still this Y bus not having any value, but just it is a zeros. And we are getting different line admittance values for all the lines available. So totally how many lines are there, that many times this iteration will form. So that is why the for loop is taken here. For I is equal to 1 up to NL, number of lines, up to N number of lines, this loop will be taken care. Okay, so here the first thing is I am going to just print, enter the following details of the line number I. Line number I is, the for example, for the first iteration of this loop, the I value will be 1. So I am telling enter the following details of the line number 1. And you will tell line number 1 is nothing but it is 0, or it is starting from 0. You will enter 0 here. So that is, that will be stored in FB, and then you will enter 1. So this 2 FB and TB, just you are telling from where to where your line is connected. Once you given that, Z is equal to, in the last line, Z is equal to input impedance value you are taking. So you are taking the impedance value of this line 1. In first iteration, so Z will get the value of the first line's value. This is just getting the data. How long it will take? It will take up to NL iterations. NL iterations is nothing but number of lines available in it. once you got all the NL values, means the impedance of different NL values, later in every iteration you are going to solve or you are going to find out the Y value also. So Y value is nothing but 1 divided by Z. For every iteration you will get this Y value also. Then you are checking if FB is greater than 0 and TB is greater than 0. Means if both starting and ending not touching any reference, 0 is reference. So if it is not reference, then what you want to do is just add your starting and starting value. FB. For example, if you are giving starting is 1 and 2, then Y11 will be your same value. Whatever the value you find out, just it will add here. And 2 will means the 2 bus. 2 is 2, 2 is 2 for example. Then Y22 will also add the same value. And Y12 is nothing but the mutual or non-diagonal element. So non-diagonal element will take the same Y value but in the negative sign. And then YTB is nothing but same as the previous value. YTB is equal to FB, means Y12 is equal to Y21. So this statement will satisfy this. This 4 line only execute when if it is not touching any reference. Suppose if it is having any reference, then TB is equal to, means the 2 bus is equal to 0, then it will add the FBB is equal to same Y value. Else if FBB is equal to 0, then 22 value will be, so it will get inverted. For 2 bus it will give the from bus value, and from bus if it is 0, then it will give 2 bus value. If you execute this in note, you will find out for every iteration how this process is taking. It will be systematically updated. In second iteration, the old value will be, old FF value will be updated with new Y value. So like this, if all iteration are going up to NL times or number of lines times, then at the final iteration, your Y bus values will be a total admittance matrix you will get. So this is how we can perform this Y admittance matrix or Y bus matrix. So finally we are going to print this, right? This is the total program for the Y bus matrix. So first we are going to take the number of lines and then number of bus, and we are forming Y bus empty Y bus matrix with the size of NB cross NB. And then for we are starting the loop for n is equal to, for I is equal to 1 up to NL. Then we are going to find out a different impedance value for all the L values. For each iteration we are going to give the Y bus, we are going to update the Y bus values also. So after completing this, the loop will get end, and then we are going to print this. So here you can see I have opened the MATLAB. This MATLAB, the same program whatever we saw in this slide, I just pasted here, and let's check how the program is running. Before that I will clear all these things. I cleared all the data. Now I just pasted the same program here. So if I start running this, it's asking number of lines. So here in this problem, we have 5 lines. So just typed 5 here. I hope it is visible to you. Number 5 lines we are having. And then number of buses excluding the references 3. So it is 3. Now I need to enter the data from bus to bus. So this is how this step is happening. So for your reference, I will keep this inside. So here, bus from bus 0 to bus 1, the value is this one. 0.055 minus 1.66 I is the admittance, but I want to give directly impedance only, because in question the impedance value only, so I need to enter this value. So that is nothing but 0 point from bus 0 to 1, the impedance value is 0.02 plus j 0.6, so this value I need to enter. So it is nothing but 0.055 minus, sorry, impedance value only we need to go. So it is 0.02. No, it is from bus, right? So from bus is nothing but from bus 0, and then it is asking two bus is nothing but 1. So the line between the bus 0 and 1, the impedance value is 0.02 plus 0.6 I. so this is the impedance value of the line bus between line between the bus 0 and 1. So first data is over. Now in second iteration it is asking to enter about the detail about line 2. Line 2, it is going from line 1 to line 2. So it is from bus is 1 to bus is 2. And then what is the impedance value? Impedance value is nothing but 0.02 plus 0.6 I. okay, so this is a line 2 data. And then I need to enter bus number from is 2 and 2 bus is 3, and the impedance value is 0.02 plus 0.5 I. next, fourth line. So totally 5 lines I have said. Now we entered into fourth line. So fourth line is from 3 to 0, and the impedance value is 0.02 plus 0.4 I. yes. And then the last line number between bus 0 to 2, and the impedance value is 0.02 plus 0.8 I. now I entered all 5 line impedance values. So totally 5 iteration it took. And for every iteration, it will find out its y value also, that is admittance value also. Parallelly, it will fill your y bus data also in respective value. Now, if I click enter, I will get my y bus value. So this is the y bus, total y bus from the code we have written here. So if you cross verify this value with our calculated value, just find out, let me check where is the calculated value. So here we have the calculated value. Here you can see the y11 is 0.11 minus 3.32. So we are getting 0.11 minus j 3.2. So we're getting the same value. And if you're going for y12, it is minus 0.5 plus j 1.6. so it is minus 0.5 plus 1.6 j, right? Here is a typing mistake. It should be 0.05. It's a typing mistake here. So otherwise you will get the same value. You can see here it is correct. So both are same value. It should be y12 and 21 are same, and it's having negative value. So as per our formula, we created the YBUS matrix. So this is the coding for YBUS matrix. Then after completing this program and the theoretical calculation, you need to verify your data which is got from, or the result you get from the MATLAB as well as the calculated values. You need to compare both the things, and you need to verify that YBUS inspection method has been successfully verified. So this is what this experiment is. So if you still have any doubt, one more time you go through this video, you will clearly get understand how this line number 13 to 16 is forming the YBUS values, or If you want to get more training, you can execute every iteration in your node. You will get to know how this value is updated. Say for example, in first iteration, if you have fb one value, in second iteration the old value will be get added with new y value. So like that we can fill all the y bus matrix with this simple logic. Okay, that's all about this experiment. This experiment number is 4.